morning to one and all present here. Today I am here to deliver a seminar on the topic artificial intelligence. First of all, let us know what is artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence in computer science, sometimes called machine intelligence, is intelligence demonstrated by machines in contrast to the natural intelligence displayed by humans and animals. The term may also be applied to a machine that exhibits traits associated with human mind, such as learning and problem solving. The ideal characteristics of artificial intelligence is its ability to rationalize and take actions that have the best chance of achieving a specific goal. The term AI was first coined decades ago in year 1956 by John M. Carthy at Dartmouth Conference. He defined AI as a science and engineering of making intelligent machines. What does it mean something to be artificially intelligent? Simply means something to have the thinking abilities which are right now accessible to human beings only. Example, audio recognition, speech recognition and decision making abilities. For a computer to really love you, for a computer to understand what you are, for a computer to understand your feelings, and for a computer to identify the difference between the sheep and a dog. For a computer to recognize, okay, it's Muskan's voice, okay, it's Ram's voice. This is something what is called as artificially intelligent. To know how to make something artificial intelligent, we first have to accept the fact that we human beings are intelligent. We are intelligent because of our brain. But how does our brain work? According to the patterns, they could be the patterns of learning, the patterns of working, and the patterns of thinking. So, for example, you are thirsty, you walked 5 kilometers apart and spotted something like this in a park. What would you do? You would sit on it. But how do you recognize that this is something to sit on? Say, in a park, you see a dog as well. Why won't you sit on it? Because our brain has learned to recognize that, okay, this is something or a place to sit. This will not be harmful for me, or this will not bite me. This example can lead to a greater motivation of the artificial intelligence. Now let us come to the need for artificial intelligence. Firstly, to create expert system which exhibit intelligent behaviors with the capacity to learn, demonstrate, explain and advise its users. Secondly, helping machines to find out solution to complex problems like humans do and applying them as algorithms in a computer friendly manner. The basic fields of artificial intelligence include: artificial intelligence is a science of getting machines to mimic the behavior of humans. Machine learning is thus a subset of AI that focuses on getting the machines to make decisions by feeding them on data. And hence, the deep learning is a subset of machine learning that uses the complex set of neural networks to solve the complex problems. Here we can see that the artificial intelligence, machine learning and deep learning are all correlated to each other. We can see that the artificial intelligence, machine learning and deep learning are correlated to each other. AI, deep learning and machine learning are interconnected fields. Machine learning and deep learning needs artificial intelligence by providing a set of algorithms and neural network to solve data-driven problems. However, AI not only relates to deep learning and machine learning, but it covers the vast domains of fields such as object detection. Like in the picture, you can see that the source is able to detect that this is a car, this is a building, this is a scooter, or this is a person. The other thing is natural language processing. Here, it is able to identify what is the nature, happy, optimistic, or sad. And here, it is used in expert systems. Also, robotics is a greater field that leads to the motivation of artificial intelligence and contains deep learning and machine learning. Benefits of artificial intelligence. Now, concepts of artificial intelligence, deep learning, and machine learning, when applied to every action in our personal lives, make us more smarter and more productive. First benefit is increased automation. AI can automate anything ranging from tasks that involve extreme labor to the process of recruitment. Such tools allow to free employees in tedious manual tasks and focus on complex tasks. A greater example is conversational AI recruiter called the MYA app. It automates tedious parts of the recruitment process such as sourcing, screening, and scheduling. Here in the picture, we can see that the automatic conversational AI recruiter is here able to talk to the person like, "Hi Lucky, this is Maya, I have few more questions." Here Lucky will be able to contact with this MYA app and directly can get recruited in the company itself. The second benefit is the increased productivity. AI has become necessary in every part of business. Solve high computational tasks. Example can be a legal robot that handle the legal paperwork and analyze legal contracts. And there are many more examples that include increased productivity using artificial intelligence. Another benefit of artificial intelligence is a smart decision making. Here in the picture itself, we can see that it is able to detect and take decision that which shirt he has to pick up, this one or that one. For example, Salesforce Einstein Analytics help to make smart decisions. Salesforce Einstein Analytics is a comprehensive AI for CRM designed to enable companies to make smarter business decisions. In the figure here, we can see that it is automatically able to make decisions and apply to the company itself. Now, the fourth and the most important benefit of artificial intelligence is a complex problem solving. Artificial intelligence is mainly used in medical diagnosis and weather forecasting. These are very complex fields which are solved easily by the help of artificial intelligence. Now consider an example of PayPal. PayPal processed about 235 billion in 2018 from 4 billion transactions by its more than 170 billion customers. Thanks to the deep learning that PayPal is able to detect frauds that are made during transaction in the companies. Now, the last benefit of artificial intelligence is personalization. AI has helped a lot in personalization. It can be overwhelming and time-consuming task, but can be simplified by the help of artificial intelligence. For example, a UK-based fashion company named Thread is able to use artificial intelligence to provide personalized recommendation for each customer, giving personal stylist to the people. Now let's come to the limitations of the artificial intelligence. As we know, everything has its pros and cons, so let us go to the limitations of artificial intelligence. Number first is AI systems are very expensive to develop and maintain. The second most important limitation is AI is data hungry. The more accurate data you feed during the process of machine learning, the more accurate will be the results. As we have limited amount of data and sources, AI cannot replicate human level of intelligence. And the last and the most important limitation is unemployment. Experts say that AI can replace all boring, repetitive and labor-intensive work that can be harmful for the man force working in the companies. Let us come to some real-life applications of artificial intelligence. All of we have heard about the Sophia, which is a humanoid robot. Sophia is a social humanoid robot developed by Hong Kong-based company Hanson Robotics. In October 2017, Sophia became a Saudi Arabian citizen and was the first robot to receive the citizenship of a country. Sophia was named the United Nations Development Programme's first ever innovation champion and the first non-human to be given any United Nations title. Cameras with Sophia's eyes combined with computer algorithms allow her to see. She can follow faces, sustain eyes contact, and recognize individuals. Around January 2018, Sophia was upgraded with functional legs and even the ability to walk. CNBC has commented on Sophia's lifelike skin and her ability to emulate more than 60 facial expressions. Navigation industry. GPS navigation system integrates AI to keep track of data such as traffic in particular area, how much time it took in the past for navigating to a particular area, and many more. The third one is research and healthcare industries. From disease protection diagnosis to robotic surgeries, AI has been helping doctors and researchers in many fields. Major contributor company is IBM Watson Health, helping doctors in development of drugs and drug research. The fourth one and the most important is creativity. AI can create a behavior and use it to create music, paint, and so on. The IBM Watson cognitive platform is one of the example of creativity of artificial intelligence. IBM Watson is a platform that represents a new era of computing based on its ability to interact in natural language, process vast amount of disparate forms of big data, and learn from each interaction. It was also used to create a movie trailer. Now let's come to some future scope of the artificial intelligence. AI in science and research. AI is making a lot of progress in scientific sector. AI can handle large quantity of data and can process more faster than human beings. AI in cyber security. Cyber security is another field that's benefiting from AI. Organizations are transferring their data to the AI networks, and the threat of hackers is becoming more significant. For example, IBM has Resilient, which is an agnostic and open platform that gives infrastructure and hub for managing security responses. AI in in data analytics, AI can identify patterns and insights that human eye cannot even notice without putting in a lot of effort. For example, Google Analytics has analytics intelligence which uses machine learning to help webmaster get insights on their websites faster. Now, let's come to the next future scope, that is AI in transport. The transport sector has been using AI for decades. Ships and spacecraft also use autopilot to help them to maintain the correct course. The next comes the most important, that is AI for domestic use, that is AI in our homes. AI has found a special place in people's home in the form of smart home assistants. Amazon Echo and Google Home are popular small home devices that let you perform various tasks with just voice commands. For example, asking a question, playing some video, buying something online. Still, there's lots of room left for improvement, but surely the scope of AI in the smart home sector is quite booming. Next comes the AI in healthcare. The medical sector is also using this technology for its advantages. AI is helping medical researchers and professionals in numerous ways. For example, the Knight Carrier Institute and Intel have made a collaborative cancer cloud. This is helping doctors in making a better diagnosis, preventing cancer from moving to higher stages, is its most effective treatment at the time. Now, we have studied about the benefits, limitations, and how the future is booming with the artificial intelligence. So, thanks a lot and thanks for your time, everybody. I hope you like my video.